Hi, I'm Jesse Lybianto. I'm the Chief Data Officer at EKRUT. Welcome to Experts Corner. The roles and responsibilities of a Chief Data Officer is to provide a data-driven transformation throughout the whole organization. This includes three components: data analytics, data engineering, and data governance. For data analytics, is to be able to provide insights and create algorithms and data science products for our clients, for our users, and for ourselves within the company. For data engineering, is so that the extraction, transformation, and load of information from input to output is streamlined and seamless. For the third one, data governance, is to ensure that the whole organization has a single source of truth. Marketing, operations, all have the same data. The most challenging aspect of a chief data officer is to convince the whole organization about having a data-driven approach in all the things that they do, and to convince them of having a data-oriented mentality. Why is that? It's because in data, it's garbage in, garbage out. The data that you put in will affect the analysis, the projections, the algorithms, and essentially the product of the whole entire system. So making sure that the engineers, the operations people, the finance, the marketing, have a clear understanding of the inputs that they put in into the system has an impact to our algorithms is very profound. How is your team structured? At EKRUT, a small startup, the structure is a little bit different than a data team in a large organization. Usually large organizations have a data science team, a data engineering team, and maybe a data analytics team. However, at EKRUT, which only consists of a few number of people in the data team, everybody has a chance to do the engineering, the analytics, the database, and the data algorithms. How important is data management in achieving company's goals? Data management is very important, especially if the company goals are already quantified. With the data management, it is easier to break down these goals into quantified subcomponents, such as objective keys or KPIs. First and foremost, a data scientist should learn SQL, or Structured Query Language. It is the language that is used to extract information from databases. It is to be able to structure these data into columns and rows, into filters, and different joins should be understood. That's SQL. Second one, I would say it's Python. A lot of data scientists learn data science and statistics because Python is very easy to learn due to its dynamic programming. Python also has a lot of data science packages that allow scientific computing, deep learning, computer vision, and many other machine learning tools. If you go deeper into the statistics and the statistical analysis, R is a very recommended tool to have. Apart from these three, if you go way deeper into developing a product, I would recommend Clojure or Julia, which are the newer data science tools, newer programming languages. What books do you most recommend to learn about data science? Data science is essentially a combination of statistics and computer science, and because of that, a very strong fundamental about statistics is required to be able to excel in data science. I recommend four different books in order for you to develop as a data scientist. The first one is business statistics for contemporary decision making by Ken Black. This is to provide the fundamental and your foundation of statistics. The second one is linear regression analysis by Douglas Montgomery. A lot of the analysis in statistics is done using regression, and a lot of the machine learning techniques that you will learn eventually are multiple forms of regression. Third one is an introduction to statistical learning. It is published by the Springer Library and was created by multiple authors. This will provide the foundation of different machine learning variables, algorithms, and how you are able to see in different multi-dimensional spaces and utilizing computer science on top of it. This book utilizes a lot of R. The fourth one is you're going to go deep into machine learning, into the realm of deep learning, where a lot of the problems are more perceptual. For this, I recommend Deep Learning with Python by Francis Collette. Here in this book, you will learn a lot more about image classification, computer vision, text sequencing, text generation, and all other deep learning applications. The attributes I value most in hiring for my team is to have a deep, proactive, and holistic approach in problem solving. First one, being deep, is to look at problems not just at the surface level, but to see problems and their root causes. Second one, being proactive. If you see something, you say something. If you see a problem, you mention it to the group, to the stakeholders, and things will get progressed and having a plan drawn out to fix the problem. The third one, being holistic, is to not just solve a problem from the perspective of, say, the data team, but to look at it from, say, an engineering team, from the ops, from the users, from the clients, from the server, all that holistic approach. All these attributes combined together are what I would say make the best engineers, and I value those in hiring for my team. These are the things I'm able to share this session. If you like the contents of this video, please like and subscribe. This will provide information for us because EKRUT TV will be producing a new video every week. If you're looking to accelerate your career, please visit us at our website, EKRUT.com. Thanks for watching. Cheers.